Hi, I'm Scott. It's Azure Friday. I'm here with Stefan talking about Azure Web Sites. So I've got a lot of websites, and I believe if we look over here on the right-hand side, most of them have custom domains. These are some of my little demo ones, and you see they have .Azure websites. But Baby Smash and Lost Phone Screen, Azure is a great way to throw up a one or two pager site.
Yes,
just when you're definitely. being silly, especially since I said before I've got a standard web, standard VM.
Mm-hmm.
So when I have an idea, I just make it happen and I throw it in there because I can have 500 websites in one VM.
It's great.
So even though Hansel Minutes is the kind of the big man on campus in that one virtual machine, I've got a little site here called Keys Left that I made with some friends. This is a thing that counts that you have a finite number of keystrokes left in your hands before you die. So, you know, how old are you? I'm 40. How fast do you type? You know, 100 words a minute. I have this many keystrokes left before I die, and it's actually counting down.
Oh, boy. Okay.
And, and it calculates how many novels.
Good. Oh, good. Well, the,
how many,
I'm pleased to see how many tweets left we have, because I think
that's the salient value, right?
That's
what we need to know, the fact that we've got, I've got 2 million tweets left. And you can see it's counting down, which is making me very sad. But really, I need to think about what the computer programs I want to write are.
Well, that's good. That's 575, so you can get at least the first 500 into one account on Azure websites
or
with a number of host names.
Right? Or we could email Scott Goo a million times. So this was a silly little site that I threw up, and it was really very simple, because once you start understanding Azure websites, as you see in some of the other videos, I made a single page. It was index.html, some JavaScript, threw it up on GitHub, hooked it up to Azure websites, and it was great. But then I needed a domain.
Ah, yes.
And I feel good about this domain. The domain is called keysleft.com, which is good because it's small.
Yes.
What is the story? When can I do custom domains in Azure websites?
So you'll see that when you're in the Configure tab, you can do custom domains if you're running in either the shared mode or if you're running in standard mode. So it is something that you do have to, even in shared mode, pay us a little bit of money in order for us to set up the host names.
Okay.
Now, I assume you're going to walk through some of the details of, like, how do you actually get the custom domain names, and then we can tie that back into how that flows back into Azure websites.
Right. So I like to use a place called DNS Simple. You might use GoDaddy or Namecheap or lots of different places. You go and you get your domain. I've got a lot of domains. Each one of these represents a personal failure. Because they are, you know, I make these domains and I think I'm going to make a startup and then I don't and then I hate myself.
Well, that's you should just wait for somebody else to make the successful startup and then charge them $1 million for the host name.
The real tragedy is the one about good Scott, bad Scott, that, you know, Guthrie and I were going to do something and it never happened. It's just sad. So we'll go to Keys Left. So I bought Keys Left for the year, okay? And if I go here and manage, and now here's this is the most important thing that people don't realize about custom domains is every DNS record system is different.
Correct.
But DNS records are not different. And this is so confusing, I think. Every time I hear someone complaining about being able to set up custom domains in Azure, it's not that they're not smart.
Yeah, it's confusing.
It's not the Azure thing that's confusing.
No,
it's DNS.
Yes.
I like DNS Simple just because I like them, because it's just very straightforward. I mean, this is unambiguous.
Yep.
It's a table that you fill out. And if I want to go and add records, there's this advanced editor. So I can go in here, and I've got my names and stuff, and I could say, add a CNAME.
Perfect. Yep.
Name. And as I'm typing in the CNAME, if I was going to say, like, mail, okay, notice that as I'm typing on the right-hand side, it's showing me, okay, mail is going to be an alias for foo.whatever.com. That makes it very unambiguous.
Yep.
Okay. So in Azure websites, I click on Manage Domains.
Right.
What's with this AW Verify thing?
So this is the thing where, you know, like everyone out there, we need to have some way to make sure that the developer, when they're typing in the domain name or names that they're registering with us, or more precisely, that they want to register with us for routing purposes in terms of actually saying, yes, there was a request to say, you know, foo.com, yes, we'll actually serve up a response back to that. We need to have some way to believe that, yeah, you probably are the owner of that actual domain, right? And so that's a critical differentiation. Ultimately, we are not a domain registrar. What you were just doing with DNS Simple, they are the registrar for the domain that we're talking about here. So the AW Verify is just a quick way to say, you know something, if you wanted, in this case, you're going for keysleft.com.
Right.
So we're saying, well, somewhere, if you actually own KeysLeft, you should go out and register this AW Verify name, which is basically, it's a fake name, right? You're not really going to use it for real.
Right.
And if you're actually able to register it with your domain registrar and we can look that up and find it, mm-hmm. we're willing to believe that the person typing in entries on this form is the same person who actually has rights to that domain on the domain registrar.
Right. So what I ended up doing was taking the Azure website and DNS Simple and then putting them side by side.
Perfect.
And I recommend this to anybody who's going to do this kind of stuff. And I go and I typed in AW Verify.
Yep, under the keys left, azurewebsites.net.
Right, is a CNAME for Azure Verify dot, AW Verify dot keys left dot azurewebsites.net.
Right, so basically on the left hand side, because that's a subdomain under keys left, that's proving that yes, you actually have rights on this domain registrar to create that kind of subdomain. And then we're just using that to cross-reference it to the simple name of the site as it exists here over on Azure Web Sites.
Mm-hmm. And this isn't used for serving traffic or anything. It's just, oh, you do really own that.
Exactly.
You're not evil completely. So then, if I was going to go and type in something like foo.keysleft.com, this is all happening kind of in real time. And you'll notice that it says, well, the DNS record could not be located. If you want foo to point somewhere, you're going to go and need to go and hook this up.
Yes. So underneath the hood, when you're typing in these various host names, I mean, we're doing two things. We're trying to make sure that, yes, you actually own the core subdomain. Also, we're trying to make sure that the name even exists in the first place.
Mm-hmm. So if I go and said something like foo is going to be keysleft.azurewebsites.net.
Great. So, yep. So ultimately for the customer, foo.keysleft.com would route into us. So you put in that new CNAME.
So I've added that there.
Great.
And I'll put this over here. And then this is where I think people get confused. How long do they wait? You know, do I wait 5 minutes or 10 minutes? It kind of all depends. Over here, there's this time to live. I never really know. Does that mean anything? Should I change that to 1 minute and hit refresh frantically?
So, I mean, this is certainly a case where when you deal with domains, you probably want to always get your domain namespace set up ahead of time, as in, like, don't wait for the product launch at 8 a.m. in the morning and suddenly decide now's a good mm-hmm. time to register custom host names.
Or a live taping.
Sure, yes, good point. But there, the TTL, ultimately what that's meant for is once the entry actually exists in DNS, mm-hmm. that if you're going to make changes to, since in this case it's a CNAME, who it's pointing at, like how long is it going to take for technically all of the intermediary DNS caches, as well as the caches on client machines, to finally expire and pick up the new value.
Right, and that is really the thing. You feel like, well, I changed it in this browser,
it should
change it here.
Right. That is not the way DNS works. It is a very laggy, asynchronous technology, shall we say.
Mm-hmm. And in this case, it's not ready yet, and we'll see how that works. But while we're waiting for that to expire between here and everywhere else, there's also your A record. Is that the computer that I pay you for?
No, that is not the specific IP address that you're paying for. There is a separate feature that, again, you can go ahead and purchase, which is you can actually buy unique IPv4 addresses mm-hmm. and then use them for your websites. But by default, what you're seeing here is the public IP address of the entire Azure Websites cluster that you're running on.
Ah, okay. So this is the load balancer, effectively.
Yes, this is effectively the IP address of the internet-facing load balancer tier.
Okay. So then when I set up my domain here, this is important, because I want to do a thing called naked domains.
Right.
Which means I want to make it so when you go to keysleft.com, it serves.
Yep.
Oftentimes you'll find you go to www, you get a site, you go to the
naked domain, and you get
nothing.
Yep.
And there's several ways you can do that. You can do it with redirects.
Yep.
You can serve it up in both places and then do a canonicalization. In the example here, I just said that www is Azure Web Sites, and then the A record pointed to here.
Yep, which is, yeah, that's a very simple way and an obvious way of doing that.
So sometimes what I'll do is I'll just clear it out, and I'll type again. It actually, I've done this before, and it goes like that.
Yeah.
I've done it other times, and you sit here for 5 minutes.
Yeah, I'm not surprised. That's why, like I said, in all seriousness, always make sure you set these up well in advance so that you don't lose any sleep over.
I tell you though, I've had really, really good luck with this stuff. I haven't found it very difficult at all. In this case here, of course, another important thing for people to remember is that this isn't my DNS that we're waiting for to. It's not my computer.
Correct. This is, I mean, underneath the hood, ultimately, this what you're typing in this form is turning into a request in a back end in Azure Web Sites, and one of our servers is actually querying, in essence, somewhat indirectly, the internet DNS, and saying, "Hey, does this host name even exist?" And
right.
So that's part of what's going on is who knows where the DNS simple servers are, how long the replication delays are for mm-hmm. it to make it around, for it to finally hit us, so that we can actually successfully resolve the domain lookup.
Exactly, and you'll notice here it does say. And the instructions, if you want to configure an A record, which is not what I'm doing, you have to do the verify. Because I've already done the verify,
yep.
I'm already cool. One thing that you can do also as a person sitting on your local machine is you yep. can type in NS lookup.
Yep, and see at least from your machine.
And I could say, well, what's foo.keysleft.com? And see that it is set up.
Ah, interesting. Okay, so we've got the alias. So that's from DNS Simple. So that now it's actually able to point into yeah. into our system.
So that means it's starting to make its way
yes.
across the wire. Now,
yes.
one of the things I can do is I could say, well, here at Microsoft, that's happened. You can see the address for the DNS at Microsoft, but I could try another server. Try Google
okay.
server. And I could do the exact same thing. Because the question is, has it reached more, you know, enough places,
right.
a typical
yep.
number of places. Another one might be Open DNS. So you could go and do this, and just by typing in NS lookup and then typing the domain, you're able to go and see that. So I'll shut this down, try it again. And there it is. So now,
yay.
You know, in the few minutes that we waited, that has come back and I hit OK. Now, you're going to then save this.
Right. So ultimately, what's happening inside of Azure Web Sites is all of those domains that you see there, we're saying, OK, for this website, we can potentially have a request coming in where the host header said it was for, you know, keysleft.azurewebsites.net, which mm-hmm. is, of course, the default, or it could be foo.keysleft.com, which you set up, or it came through the A record, et cetera, et cetera. Ultimately, it's just a matter of us programming the load balancer to say, yes, this is a domain name we recognize, and oh, by the way, it's associated with this specific website, so we know how to route the HTTP traffic.
Yeah, even though we had to wait a minute or two there, it's a good reminder to people that if you're waiting an hour or two or eight, it's probably your configuration.
Yes, correct.
Cool, it's custom domains on Azure Websites on Azure Friday.